Hello everyone, this is Ashwin, back with another interesting topic. Now I'm going to explain you about MVC architecture. What does MVC stands for? MVC stands for Modal View Controller Architecture. Modal View and Controller. When you search for definitions in the internet, you will find many definitions about MVC architecture. But I think it is not good to understand each other. According to the internet, MVC is nothing but a software architecture pattern used for designing web applications. But this is not a good thing to remember. So I will give you a practical example to know what MVC does and what is MVC stands for. Now let us take an example that you are the user. You go to restaurant, right? This is you, user. You go to restaurants. What you can do if you go to restaurant to do you can go to restaurants for eating something, right? You don't prepare there. You need to buy the product and buy the item and you can eat. So you can search for waiter first. A waiter will receive your interest of what you have to eat, and he will take the request to the client. Client in the sense, a cook, right? He can cook for you. So a user requests, interacts with the waiter only. He doesn't interact with the cook. He doesn't directly go to the cook and I want this item, you can give, please give me. He don't ask like that. He can only interact with the waiter, and waiter interacts with the cook to do some items. And cook has many recipes, he knows many recipes. So among the from that recipes, the cook will select the item which the waiter asks, so that cook prepares a recipe and again he will give it to the waiter. So waiter again gives it to the user, and this ends the task. From this I can compare with MVC architecture. Here user is a view and cook is a model, and here the waiter is the controller. So well, coming to web application development process, what are the these things stands for? View is nothing but the user. That means we are the users for a particular website. And the controller is nothing but a code, software code. So that you can write a code to do some particular operation. So model is nothing but a database. It can store the entire data. So from this, a user requests some data from this web application. So who can perform this web application? Who can extract the data from the database? Here is the controller. Controller is nothing but a software code which is used to do a particular task. So the view, the user requests a database by using some software code. This is the architecture in which a general web design application will follow. These are the, MVC architecture plays an important role in many application developments. Of course, many languages use this kind of databases and this kind of MVC architecture to do a particular task. So, in preferable, please remember this example if you have any doubts about MVC architecture. This will clear your minds. Again, I am repeating that a user will access the data from the database by using the software code. The user is a view, the software core is the controller, and the database is the model. So user extracts the data from the model by using a controller. This is what generalized view of MVC architecture. Thank you for watching.